This is a video detailing the skills I used in Premiere. It's on Premiere Photoshop to create my magazine front cover. First of all, I want to go over the settings we used in the camera to actually achieve the picture we took. So the shutter speed, we set this to be very quick so the camera wasn't shaking and the picture was very clear. We then adjusted the aperture. A small aperture will give you a blurry background, a large aperture will give you a clear background. We had a slightly larger aperture so that the bricks in the background were not blurry and so we could see how centralised the subject's face was. We played around with the ISO as well because we were outside and we had a low ISO so we wouldn't have much noise. When we actually got to Photoshop, we imported the photo, we then duplicated it, changed the blending mode so the top layer was vivid lighting. This made it bright on the inside, and then with the top layer we inverted it so we had one inverted with vivid lighting and another plain image. After this we added surface blur, which is found in filter. We set both of the radiuses and thresholds to 40, and this meant the picture was slightly distorted. After this we duplicated both images and merged the layers so we had one centre image. After this we did the middle layer, the inverted layer, so we just left with the original mode layer. We then desaturated the top layer. This confirmed image, adjustments, and desaturate. This gets rid of any random distortion in the picture. We then played around with shadows, which is found in image, adjustment, and shadows. Shadows and highlights, sorry. We set the shadows to 0, increased mid-tones to 25, and then merged layers, adjusted shadows and highlights to achieve the effect you see. We then put it into black and white, and this is simply achieved by going into the image and then black and white. We then played around with some of the colours, specifically the red and yellows. This brings out the texture of the skin. We then added a vignette, and we do this by adding a solid colour layer and set to hashtag FFFFF. We then used an elliptical marquee tool and selected the area we wanted. We then filled it. This led us to a drop-down box and we set it to 175. This created a white background. We then inverted the layer, adjusted the opacity to achieve a desired effect. We then created another vignette and moved it off the photo so that the darker side of it was around the director's face, and this gave us the half shadow, because if you see the shadow without the vignette, there's no shadow, so we have to artificially create shadow and there is a white outline on the picture, but for some reason it didn't show up on the Photoshop file when I opened it. This was simply made by creating a rectangle. I'll show you the picture with the white background in a moment. There you can see there is a white background, but for some reason it didn't show up in Photoshop. This was simply made by creating a square, adjusting the opacity to be 0, but then we made a fill around the outside. We then changed the size of the fill, and also made the colour white. You can't see what I'm doing in Photoshop, for some reason recognise it's there, but that's what we did. We then got a BFI logo off the internet and erased everything around it, but it didn't look great when we put it in there, so we luckily found another one with no background so that we didn't have to erase anything, and it looked pretty good when we imported it. The barcode is simply cropped from another magazine and imported and removed to the conventional place on the other side of sound magazines. With the date and time you see in the top right corner, this was simply made by creating a box and then finding that the font that looked was the same as the one on Sight & Sound magazines and then putting that in. The Sight & Sound logo you see is just one from the magazine that we took and then erased everything around it, so we just had the text. And then we move on to the George Fools part of the magazine. Now, George Fools is the name of our director, and this was again, it was a bit of a creative trial and error process. We imported the text using the text tool. We chose the font. Initially, we had italic black and white colour scheme, but we later on decided that this magazine was quite sophisticated, and we sort of went with a bit more of a low-key but still stylish font. We also initially had the George white and the Fool's black, but when the Fool's was black, you couldn't see the tie, and it also blocked out a lot of the hand. This detracted from the vignette and the other aspects of the background image. So what we did was we changed the colour to a sort of light grey. We decreased the opacity of the text. And then we made a film around both the George and the Fool's. This meant that the outline of the letters was there, so they were still quite visible, but it meant that you were still able to see the full quality of the George and the Fool's. Now we move on to the every new film reviewed aspect of this product. And we couldn't copy this from a science hammer magazine, as the quality was just not good enough. So we created our own. This was made by importing a circle, just a general red circle, and then creating text and putting it inside the circle, so pretty straightforward there. So we had the colour scheme completely right with everything. We took a colour swap of the and of the Sight and Sound. Is both the end and every new film reviewed on actual Sight and Sounds are the same colour. We then adjusted the red in the circle to be the same colour. With the text below the George Fool's, you see it has Deep Focus and Tarkovsky, Legacy, Toronto Reports, everything like that. The circles are made by just creating ellipses and making the colour the same as that of the Sight and the Sound. We then obviously move those so they were perfectly aligned with everything else. The key parts of those are put in bold because that's what they do in Sight and Sound. And everything on there is taken from previous Sight and Sound magazines. Now the final key part of our front cover was the smoke protruding from our director's mouth. Initially we just had the smoke that was in the photo, but we decided that it wasn't quite visible enough. So what we did was we created a rectangle. We then adjusted the fill and the opacity, and made it white, and we angled it and placed it so that it looked like the smoke was continually going off the page, just gave it some more visibility. The reason we did that is because across all three of our media texts, smoke is a key aspect of noir films, so we wanted that sort of familiarity in transmedia navigation within the noir pieces. So those are the Photoshop skills I use to create a front colour. Thanks for listening.